You've probably already seen the live preview and know that you can click on this button to make it work. In this video, I want to talk about a few details on how it works and how you can make it work with dynamic websites like a WordPress site and what the limitations are when you do that. First, I want to mention that there's a keyboard shortcut to start up the live preview and turn it off. Control or Command plus Alt plus P. There are more important shortcuts to remember in the beginning, I think, but it's good to know about for when you have more room in your brain for another one. The live preview is often a good alternative to working on your CSS in the browser with web developer tools, but sometimes you'll still want to inspect items. When you do this, it will disconnect your live preview, as you can see in this message right here. If I click on it again, a new tab opens up. Remember that this first tab won't reflect changes in your code unless you save and refresh, so you'll probably want to close that tab. Notice that even if I don't have any files open, if I start up the live preview, it will find the index.html file and open it. Index.html is part of my working file set now. If I go ahead and open the 404 HTML page, it will change the live preview to that page instead. So the preview is either index.html or whatever page is active in the editor. In static HTML websites, any HTML you change will be reflected in the browser immediately when you're in live preview mode, even the title tag. And of course, the content changes as I type. I don't even have to save my changes for the new text to be shown in the browser. Now, if I don't have any files open and I don't have an index.html file in my project folder, I'll run into a problem. I'll rename index.html to pc.html. Now, if this file is active, live preview will work, but if I'm on a different file and I try to start live preview, I get this message. It's telling me I need to have an index.html file in my folder or I need to open an HTML file. If I make pc.html active, it will work. This live preview will work for pages that use PHP as well, although not in the same way, and you do need to set it up first. I'll open an old website that was created with PHP but is still fairly static. When I try to do the live preview here, it tells me I need to enter my local URL. I'll do that now. And it goes ahead and starts the preview. This URL is saved in the project settings and will be set for this project, so you won't need to type this in every time. The live preview will work on these pages and it will work on any page I have open. However, if I change the HTML, I will need to save it before we see the changes. If I open style.css, however, we can see that any changes I make to the CSS are applied immediately. You can get the live preview to work with a WordPress website as well. I'll open up a WordPress website and set the URL for the project. Now, if I try the live preview, it starts up just fine. And if I try to make changes to the styles, they're shown right away. So the live preview works great for seeing your changes right away in the browser. It knows to look for an index.html file and open it in the preview. If one does not exist, you need to open the file you want to preview first. It will also work with dynamic pages, but you need to set up the project URL first for this to work. The changes to the HTML won't be shown until you save your changes, but CSS changes will still be shown on the fly.